Hey man, I'm Chris with Phone Cats. I don't know if I can even handle this video, dude. Look up there. Look at my gems. It says 250 gems. I'll spend all day playing Card Wars and being able to open one algebraic chest. And we're about to open up so many. Oh, and what a coinky dink. Imagine that. It's a rare card carnival. So we're gonna dump $150 towards algebraic chests. And it's during a rare card carnival. Video's ruined, oh god. This is all brought to you by DUJ2. He threw me $100 on an iTunes gift card, and All-Star 1402 threw me another $50 on top. So, thanks so much, guys. You guys are crazy. I love you. Thank you. Now, first we're gonna beef up our inventory space. Increase inventory, I think I need to do this like 10 times. 1 2 Okay. 3 Okay. 4 The game's not even gonna handle this. 5 6 Everybody's saying that I need to do this 10 times. 7 8 9 10 All right. Y'all ready? We'll do God card, bad card, like maybe every 10 chests. Gamble open. 1-300-0 God or bad. Alright, let the games begin, guys. And yeah, once again, thanks to DUJ2 and All-Star 1402. You little devils. I'll let you guys gamble, and we'll do it maybe like once every 10 cards or so. Let's get this going. Typing out gamble close now. Y'all better be quick. It's so cool that we're doing this during a rare card carnival, though. You have 3 times the chance to get rarity 4- and 5-star cards. This was timed so well. Alright, we'll close out gamble in just a second. And there was a mini drama bomb. We almost didn't do this. When DUJ2 threw me $100, it was accidentally in the form of an Apple Store gift card. So I almost had to buy, like, Apple Store things, like a new iPad. But he's such a globster. He went ahead and just threw me another $100 iTunes. My god. Alright. First one. The hype is real. Let the games begin. Portal of Nowhere, return all of your creatures on the field to your hand. Gamble winner bad. Gamble winner bad. Why? Why would you want to do that? You guys blew it. That's the end of this video. I can't handle it. Puffy? A Puff Daddy castle? Heal 5 damage from your hero whenever a creature in this lane is destroyed. Where are my gold cards at? I said I had 3 times the chance. Off to a bit of a rough start. Let's pop that chest open. Inside. Cow? I'm about to have a cow. We know this card! We know this card! 3 times the chance for rarity 4- and 5-star cards! Dog boy! Not bad. Not bad. You guys already broke Modbot, that didn't take long. Chests! We had 250 gems, we're down to 225. Steak chop! This is my first steak chop. There's somebody on the Card Wars subreddit that loves steak chop. 4 mana for a 2015. Digging the aggro. Flip them for 2. Deal 2 damage to the opposing creature for each of your opponent's discarded creatures. This is the best card that we've gotten so far, people. Steak chop. Alright. Very interesting. So this is good late game. That's better late game. If you play that as soon as you can on turn 3, and you got nothing in your graveyard, it's not doing too much for you. Phyllis! Old lady with a dagger. Rainbow. 515. Cough syrup. During the first DUJ2 powered algebraic chest opening, I got 2 cough syrup. Now I'm up to 3. So we got big combos. And you guys are flipping out about Modbot. Fine. Alright, he's coming back up. Another cough syrup? I better not get more than 4. You can only play with 4 of the same card in a deck. So cough syrup flips the stats on a creature. It's like the igloo too. Alright, Modbot back in the house. We'll confirm it with the P-coins. Pardon me, the DU chest, DUJ2 and Spyro chest opening. I see you, Spyro. Chestburster! What is my first gold card gonna be? P-coins, add, online, we'll give all of y'all 300 that you do not deserve. Eat them. Let's keep cruising. We're almost a fifth done though, guys! Where are my gold cards at? Normal patchy? That's either my fourth or fifth patchy. But let's keep moving. Yeah, y'all are breaking Modbot down. So we've opened up 10 chests so far. We have 70 left. Yes! Alright. Another rainbow barfer. I got a gold one, but that's good. That's good. We'll keep moving. I better get a gold card. Puffy Castle, no! Heal 5 damage from your hero whenever a creature in this lane is destroyed. Oh god. Alright, there's Modbot. Very rare. Oh, I thought it was gold, but it's yellow. That's my second Marianne. She's really consistent. But nothing too crazy. Alright guys, we just passed 200. We're at 198. Ooh, my first Sergeant Mushroom. 4 mana for a 26-14. That's actually really good for a heart card. Choose an opposing creature, deal 4 damage to it, and heal this creature 6 points. That's one of the better cards that we've gotten so far, dude. Alright, let's keep moving. Show me gold. Show me gold! Heifergeist. Another good card. It's good for blue. I don't know. I think I already have two of those. I don't think I have a gold one, though. I can't remember. Spyro said that Sergeant Mushroom is one of the best four drops. Eh, debatable. Come on. Papa needs a new gold card. Pickler, he's alright. 4 mana, 12-8, lower the defense of all opposing creatures by 5. So same ability as, what's her face? Dark Angel, right? Not bad. Alright, we'll try playing God Card, Bad Card for this next one. Gamble open, 1-100-0, God or Bad. So you guys can gamble again. Only 100 on this one. Max bet is 100. Because, last time it just crashed. So I can't be giving out 300 P coins each time. And just to give y'all a reference of how thankful I am, like, right now we're gambling for up to 100 P coins. But, I threw GUJ2 10k P coins. And, All-Star 1402. He got 5k. I'm giving y'all all this fake money. And you guys think it comes from nowhere, but I make these P-coins with my blood. My blood. Alright, typing out gamble close now. We gotta keep this going. That last chest opening vid, when we did it for $85 worth, was like 45 minutes long. But we were gambling way too much. Alright. Gamble close. Here we go. Gold card. First gold card. You get a gold card. You get a gold card. You get a gold card. All right. Gamble. Winner. God. Y'all know I love gold cards. That's a god. How'd y'all bet? I know everybody bet on it being bad. Watch. It's gonna take forever for the bets to show up. But if ModBot eventually poops this out, y'all are gonna get paid. Let's see if it shows how y'all bet. It said bets locked in, but it didn't even tell me. Alright, we're gonna have to give that a while and see if it'll even go through. While we wait, 4 mana for a 748. Floop it, destroy a building in the opposing lane. Dude, a lot of these guys are playing with buildings nowadays. I don't even get it. You said Gold Sandfoot was a bad card last time. And I kind of think it is. Look at this thing's defense. Turn 4, 48 defense, and it eats buildings. I don't know. I'm just hyped for it. And it's the first gold card. Perhaps our only gold card. Alright. We'll see if ModBot ever follows through with that payout. We're going to give him like 10 minutes and wait it out. Another chest burster. I'll take it, dude. So, the more cards that you have in your hand with this guy, the more you hit your opponent directly to the face. Epically, I'll still give you cool points, man. I respect you for earning your P-coins straight up. But I see what you're saying. I feel you, man. Another cow. Oh, no. I was pretty hyped for that gold card, but then we open a cow. Need something to cheer me up. Something to lift my spirits. A Psionic Architect is good. In certain combo decks, he's killer. Like in the Which Way combo deck, return a spell from your discard pile to your hand. If I catch one or two more of these, I'm gonna build a deck to where I just play Volcano and Cerebral Bloodstorm, and every turn I just keep pulling things back from the graveyard. That's the motion. Pull it back from the graveyard, play it. Pull it back from the graveyard, play it. They're not gonna know what hit them. Alright, let's keep moving. Guys, we started out with 250 gems. We're down to 180. Sludger! That is like my third Sludger. He's really good. I mean, 3 mana for a 15-15 is straight up solid. His floop's unique, but good. You basically give 2 of your creatures a total of plus 8, minus 4. You gotta kinda play around him, but let's keep moving. It shows me the art first for like a nanosecond. And sometimes I wonder if it's going to be a gold card or not. This is my second Cactus Thug, so now I can do better combos with 2 of them. Like Cactus Thug, it might be Schoolhouse, which is really good. But yeah, 2 Cactus Thug is solid, and that's a 5-star rare, dude. His defense is a little humble. Deal damage to creature in the opposing lane equal to this creature's defense. So it's all about pumping up his defense, dude. I don't even know what to think. The combo of like getting a gold card and then getting a Detective Bobby. Yeah, that's the combo. It's like thumbs up because it's a gold card and then thumbs down because it's a Detective Bobby. So it evens out and I put my thumbs towards me and then I just want to gouge my eyes out. Y'all know I really don't like Detective Bobby. But let's give it a second. 3 mana for a 7/32. Adjacent creatures heal 6 points. This would normally be garbage, but DUJ2 saying during cough syrup or put an igloo on him. And then it's 3 mana for a 32/7. And that basically makes him Apache the Pumpkin with a better buff. I don't know, kind of trolly. What up, Boone? Popping in and out. I see you. All right. Let's keep moving. That was our second gold card. Ooh, well-dressed wolf. Heal all damage from this creature. 10/18. Not bad. Not bad. This might be my first well-dressed wolf. Alright, guys. We're sneaking up on spending 100 gems. But we're not even halfway done. Let's keep this going. Falling Star, that may be my 4th one. So we're fine there. Did Modbot come back or no? Alright, we've opened up 25 chests. Guys, there's only 55 left. That's still a lot. Oh my god. Woo-wee. Gold Lady Mary. 4 mana for a 27/30. Dang, Mary. Them stats. Increase the defense of your creatures by 2 for each building you control. God, they're trying to make me a building deck. So if you got 4 buildings somehow, you pump up all your dudes by 8. 4 mana for a 27/30 is good to me, dude. That doesn't seem bad. Some people are saying bad. Yeah, and her animation? She gets wiggly leg. Y'all know I love gold cards. I love them. Hot Dog Rain, can't summon buildings. No. Nah. Not like this. Alright, looks like ModBot's dead. It's official, guys. Sorry about that. I really wanted to see how that bet was gonna go, because that was a god card. Dr. Death. Normal Dr. Death. My swamp deck is going to be so gross, dude. Dr. Death is worshipped in this game, and it's all because of his attack. That 33 attack is just intimidating. I have the gold version. I think he gets pumped up to... Is it 51 or 52? Either way, now I have one normal Dr. Death and two gold... No, one gold Dr. Death and two normal Dr. Deaths. So any swamp deck is now OP. Alright, let's keep moving. Oh, I wanted a gold record thug. That's fine. This might be my third or fourth record thug. 3 mana for an 820. Deal damage to opposing creature equal to the damage on this creature. So, if you do any kind of buff stuff with him... Yeah, that buff stuff. Like, if you pump up his defense by 10, and then he takes 25 damage, when you floop him, he'll hit the opposing creature for 25. Unless I'm mistaken. Either way. He's solid. He's good for a 3-star rare. Yeah, ModBot's dead. We can't do any more gambles. He can't handle it right now. Cave of Solitude. I got a couple of these now. 1 mana. Creatures in this lane get +5/+5 for each of your empty lanes. So you play 1 creature, and then this. And that creature gets +15/+15. That's really not bad. But the more lanes you fill up, the less benefit he had. This thing gives it. It'll get to the point to where all your lanes are full, and your creature gets +0/+0. Yeah, we'll do a refund, but we can't do any more gambles with it. He just dies over and over. I'll shut him down and open it again. Alright, we got the gold heifer, dudes. We're hitting some hotness now. Pulling back ModBot, but let's get chatty about gold heifer. I like the normal heifer. I was talking about how that's a decent card straight up. Let's see... P-Coins, add, online, 100. There's y'all's money back. But dude, gold heifer. Negate all damage, defense, and attack modifiers on this card. So, let's say they play Apache the Pumpkin and hit it for 22 damage. All you do is flip it for 2 mana, and all damage goes away. So this takes away all the debuffs, but it takes away all the buffs too. So you gotta kinda play around it. Good card though. Alright, let's keep moving. I hope this gives y'all a feel of if it's worth it to buy chests in this game or not. Husker Bat. Alright. It's a good card. It's consistent, and it has high defense. It's almost like a reversed Patchy the Pumpkin. Sometimes I like to go super aggro and play Patchy, but lately I've been playing with Husker Bat, and it works out, dude. Alright, everybody got those 100 P-Coins refunded. Let's keep this popping. I don't know how many gold rainbow cards I have, but now we got it. 3 mana for a 715 for a Ghost Ninja. Deal 4 damage to creature in the opposing lane and heal this creature for 5 points. Dude, some gold cards are broken almost. Like, the fact that you heal him up for 5, and his defense, it would normally be 10, but since he's gold, his defense is 15. So for 1 mana, you're flicking a Ninja Shuriken, hitting it for 4, and then healing him for 5. and his attack is bumped up. That ain't bad. People are saying sub hype, what did I miss? Enchanted Fort just subbed for the second month in a row. Man, these peak ones are gonna be crazy. Enchanted Fork, thank you. Enchanted Fork, thanks so much for resub, dude. And you're a repeater, man. Multiple months. Thanks a lot, dude. Peacoins, add online. We'll throw out 111. Bam! Thanks again, Enchanted Fork. You're super nice, dude. Alright. Yet another shout out to DUJ2 and AllStar1402. This wouldn't be possible without them, guys. And I wouldn't have opened up a Detective Sally without you. Wait, that's not good. Let's keep moving. Okay. Wait, what do I hate? Is it Detective Sally or Detective Bobby? I think I hate all the cards. Wait for chat to see this. I was hype for the gold mushroom. Alright, and Shadow Nuke Pie. He said he wanted to save it for Grotopia, but he wants to dump it now. Shadow Nuke Pie resub too. Shadow Nuke resub hype! And we'll throw out more coins. He said he wanted to save it for Grotopia, but he wants to spam it out now. That's fine, man. And I'll throw out P-Coins too. P-Coins, add online, 133. Alright, sub hype, and we just caught a gold Sergeant Mushroom. 4 mana for a 39-21? Are you kidding me? That attack, dude. Heart cards are not supposed to be this good. 4 mana for a 39-21, and same routine. Choose any opposing creature, deal 4 damage to it, and heal this guy up for 6. This might be my best heart card. I said it. Alright guys, we're not even at the halfway point. Are you kidding me? We're not even halfway done with this. Snake Eye Ring. Alright, don't scoff at this card. In the one turn kill combo deck, turn one, which way? No creatures on the board, Snake Eye Ring. Draw 4 cards for 3 mana. Compare that to a Bubblegum Butt, which I think is 3 mana, draw 2 cards. You just gotta play this at the right time, and you get double Bubblegum Butt value. Not bad. Not bad. Alright, let's keep moving. Throne of Doom, destroying your creatures, gain 4 magic points. I don't really see the use of this card, but it is a 4-star rare. So we'll try to look for combos down the line. Right now, I can't think of anything. Let's keep moving. A shout out to Epically. He's one of the first people that got close to breaking 30k P-Coins organically. Because when people donate iTunes gift cards, I'll throw them change. But Epically's doing it organically. Ooh! This is my first Struzan Djinn, dude. This card is a copycat of a Magic the Gathering card. Magic the Gathering. In old school Magic, there was a card that maybe was from Arabian Nights. And basically, it looked a lot like that too. I wish I could pull up the art, but I can't. But it was called Juzam Djinn. And it was a good card. The thing that's gross about this is you're flooping for 3 mana, send creature in opposing lane back to opponent's hand. So every time that you do that, you floop him, he gets to hit your opponent's face, and they can't just play something to block the lane. Every time you bounce him back, it's gross. Alright, let's keep moving. Well, we talked about it earlier. And now he is here. Bubblegum Butt. I was way off, dude. I thought it was 3 mana to draw 2 cards. That might be a different butt. I can't keep my butt straight. Bubblegum Butt, 5 mana, draw 3 cards. This shows you how good the other card is. Alright, looks like All-Star 1402 is tapping out, like, right in the middle of our chest opening. That's fine, dude. The chests that you bought were the first ones that I opened. So you got to see me open up yours. And I'll upload this to YouTube so you can catch the rest, man. Okay, so check it out. Bubblegum Butt, 5 mana, draw 3 cards. Snake Eye Ring, 3 mana, draw up to 4 cards if you play it pro. And chat confirmed it. I'm thinking of Strawberry Butt. So many butts. Let's keep moving. Green Mermaid. I got a couple. Sometimes I run her, sometimes I don't. Deal 3 damage for each of your buildings to creature in the opposing lane. Dream situation. You got 4 buildings, you hit the opposing creature for 12, and then attack it for 11. That's super strong, but that's the dream situation. Like, realistically, the flip's only 1 mana. Realistically, maybe you play a creature in a building turn 1, turn 2 this, turn 3, maybe another building, and then floop it, hit it for 6, and then attack for 11. That's 17 damage. Not bad. Barracuda's tapping out. See you later, dude. Alright, we're past the halfway point. We've already pulled a lot of good cards, dude. Fummy. 4 mana for a 10/24. This creature and adjacent creatures get +6 defense. Not bad. No, Car. I'm gonna do a normal stream. We're gonna keep going. This is just the Card Wars video. Fummy's okay. Palace of Bone. Here's the buildings that we're talking about. Deal 5 damage to opposing creature whenever a new creature is placed in this lane. Wow, dude. So, like, swamp deck with this and that mermaid that we were just looking at. You play the mermaid and flooper on the same turn. Not bad. Not the craziest, but not bad. Let's keep moving. Eiling! I ain't mad. 3 mana for a 7/21. Floop him. Deal 4 damage to creature in opposing lane and its adjacent creatures. You guys are saying blind opening? Yeah, I'll do one without looking, but I don't even know, man. It's not like we can gamble because Modbot keeps crashing. You guys just love to know what the card is before me. I'll just look at chat. Which is gonna be hard. Alright, we're tight. Can't see it. I'm waiting for chat to say something. All I see is Shadow Nuke Pie saying, "You're welcome for the resub." Thanks, dude. Everyone's saying, "Ha ha ha." And OMG Gold? I can't wait for you guys to make me a detective deck. I don't even know what we're gonna call it. What's the popular detective? We'll call it Sherlock Holmes. It's just gonna be Detective Sally's, Detective Bobby's, and Buildings. God. Of course, the one time that I don't look at it. We pull a gold detective. Another cave of solitude? Make it stop. Alright guys, we're almost down to 100. Good King Wonderful. I have a gold Good King Wonderful, and I run him in a combo deck. To where, it's either done through cough syrup, or the Christmas building, whatever it's called. And you can flip him. He's still not bad, because the floop is the same. Choose one of your creatures and heal all damage from it. If you're running a deck with a whole bunch of high defense stuff, you can almost get to the point to where they can't kill you. God, I might make a fatigue deck. Or I just run my opponent out of cards. It's gonna be so rude. You guys are saying do another blind. We'll do it after this one. Thank you. This is my first Corn Lord. And I thank the Corn Lord. Oh, my green screen is getting a little flicky. It can't even handle all these chests. My green screen is a chest, man. Alright, we're back. Dude, this is my first Corn Lord. Choose a creature and give it +6 attack. You floop him for 2 mana. So I'm not too sure what the angle is there, or what the deal is. It's okay that, it's only 2 mana, and he's a 1038. I don't know what to think though. One of my favorite things about him is whenever you play him, he makes a fart sound. That's all. Alright, let's keep moving. That's one of the better cards though, dude. Alright. Ooh, I am running out of chest space. Wow, guys, we're gonna hit like a tipping point in the middle of the vid. I know what we're selling. Like 50 bubblegum butts. Alright, no look. Just chat. That didn't sound like a good card. I'm waiting for chat to give me a hint. Any thoughts? Someone said butt? It better not be another butt. Give me a hint, guys. Just give me a hint. Someone said Gold Sergeant Mushroom, OMG, Husker Giant. Ah, Husker Giant. Yeah, y'all nailed it. I do already have a Husker Giant, and mine's gold. I think I even have 2 gold Husker Giants. But, that ain't bad at all. +2 attack for each Cornscape you have. So in an all corn deck, you flip him for 1 mana, and he gets +8. Alright, let's keep moving. Car keeps saying he has $200 in App Store. Want me to donate $100? Nah, man, keep it. You're fine. Alright. I'm getting so many new cards, dude. This is my first Captain Taco. And he looks cooler than I ever could have imagined. 5 mana for a 15-30? Lower the opposing creature's attack by 1 for every card in your opponent's hand. Dude, that's such a weird ability. Lower the attack of the opposing creature by 1 for every card in your opponent's hand. So if they got like 5 cards in their hand, and you flip it, you just lower it by 5? That's okay for 1 mana. I think the selling point is that his defense is 30. So if you're doing this every turn and chipping away at their hand, or chipping away at their creature's attack, it'll be hard to kill him. Not bad. Alright. Whoa, we gotta make room for some inventory in just a little bit. Stop it. Stop with the detectives. Oh god. Alright. After this, we need to sell off some garbage. Another chest burster. I might be up to 4, dude. What we're gonna end up doing is building like an all chest burster deck. To where I just play 4 chest bursters and then every turn floop them all. And then let's say I have like 6 cards in my hand. Deal 2 damage to the opposing hero for every card in your hand. So that would be 12, 12, 12, 12. That's 48 damage. Not bad. Alright, now we gotta make room. Let's go sell off something not good. Sell cards. Alright, a couple people keep spamming. Come on guys, y'all gotta be cool. Okay. The thing is, I don't even know what to sell. We'll hawk a traveling farmer. Fluffapillar, Ordinary Wizard, no, this'll be easy. Freezy J Mouthball. God, I have a lot of good cards now. Oh my god, all these new cards. Kinda wanna sell Phyllis. God, Dragonfoot? Phonecats, how you get the best cards? Donates. Alright. I don't even know what else to sell, dude. I can get rid of 1 sand jackal. Probably that normal sand foot. Wow. I don't know how we're gonna find room for all this. We still have 27 more? I mean, I'll sell off some buildings too, but dude. Get rid of a Bloodstorm. Oh, I kind of like those. But I can get rid of a Falling Star. Hot Dog Rain, sure. I think I have an extra Witch Way. I got 2 Pie Storm. We'll dump 1. Is that enough? It's not. Buildings? Alright, I can get rid of stuff. I kind of want to get rid of Sand Sphinx, but they might be good. We'll dump 1 Cave of Solitude. I have so many of those. That's still not enough, dude. I can't keep selling things off. Let's just go back to opening. But yeah, man. I can't keep up with this. Back to the hotness, no look. What are you guys thinking? It'd be great if you gave me a hint. And not just said the card name in chat immediately. I didn't look. Everybody's saying immortal? Tough call, dude. Immortal Mazewalker, I love what he says more than I love the card. Let's see if I can say it and get strep throat immediately. I love corn! Was that it? Was that good? 5 mana for an 1136, deal 33 damage to any opposing corn creature. So basically you can wreck somebody's deck if they're playing a corn deck. They can't even handle it. Oh my god, my throat. Some of these butts are so bad, it's shocking. Banana butt. One mana. Destroy one of your creatures, draw one card. I don't know when this would be good. No idea. Ice Paladin! Pretty meh. He's a rainbow, so they're kind of always a little so-so. He's got a cool sword. I'll give him that much. 3 mana for a 3/12. Adjacent creatures gain plus 5 defense. I don't know what to think. Yeah, guys, I feel like the butt collector. Give me all the butts. Davy Bear. Second Davy Bear for me. Another card that can deal face damage directly to your opponent. Yeah, too much spam, dude. Whoever keeps spamming, if I get you IP banned, you can't even watch Twitch anymore, dude. So don't push it. Alright. Another cough syrup! The combos are going to be off the charts. But that might be our fourth or fifth. Second one. God, y'all got such lag. Dude, every one of my heart decks. Oh, baby, a triple, but a double. My heart decks are gonna be good. Watch. I bet I'm gonna fall in love with all those detective cards. Like, with Double Sergeant Mushroom, Detective Bobby and Detective Sally might be relevant. Oh my god. Like, we're expanding our card collection, but I'm expanding my mind. Guys, this could already be done, and I'd be so happy. And we still have, what is that, 22 left? Wow. Temporal Wisp. This is one of the better floops in the game, dude. 3 mana for a 9/17. Opposing creature cannot attack on opponent's next battle phase. So check it out. I got Struzam Djinn bouncing cards back to their hand. I got Temporal Wisp. Your dudes can't even attack. I got, I'm ramping up with that Poultrygeist. So all these things are happening quicker. All the decks need to be reworked. All the decks. Never even have had this card before. She's an underwater ghost hag. 4 mana for a 10/28. Choose a friendly creature and negate all damage, defense, and attack modifiers on it. So this is the Heifergeist that can do it to any other creature on the board. That's on your side. Really weird. We're gonna have to play with it and see how that goes. I don't even know how to play it. Let's keep moving. Oh my god, guys. We've already passed 1 hour of opening chests. Ba-da-ba-ba-ba! I'm loving it. Golden Psionic Architect. I like the normal one, dude. 3 mana for a 25/12. Patchy Who. Patchy the Who. 2 mana to floop it. Return a spell from your discard pile to your hand. Man, now I need to look at all my spells again. Because each one, I can play over and over and over. Y'all want a blind opening? It sounded good. That sounded like a good card. What do we got? What's in the box? What's in the box? Someone said cow, someone said bubble butt, someone said boop, someone said boo, cow? God, these cows! I hate them. I hate to say it, but I hate these cows. It's not a bad card. I'm so used to playing Dr. Donut, dude, that I can always pull creatures back from the graveyard. But maybe this will be good in non... No, you can play Dr. Donut with any deck. We'll see what the deal is. PCAT's fan said, got milk. Punk cat! One time, I sold a punk cat, and chat rioted. I didn't think it was very good, but it is. 3 mana, activate an adjacent creature's floop ability, if applicable. We've kind of went back and forth on it, but I'm pretty sure that even if you've already flooped the creature, this will allow you to floop it again. Can this do double floops or no? Can Punk Cat do double floops? We'll see what chat says. Oh, I can't? Some people saying yes. Almost everybody said no, though. He's okay. I have a copy already. Extra large spirit soldier. Floop him for 1 mana. Return this creature to your hand and draw a card. I don't even know how I'm going to be able to do this. But there might be a way. I might even have a gold one. But the cool thing is... Let's say this guy gets down to like... under 10 HP. You floop him for 1 mana, you get to draw a card, and you replay him with full health. Some people are saying cough syrup. Interesting. Interesting. Alright guys, I gotta sell off some more stuff. Should I sell cards? Or buy space? I don't know what to do. People are saying sell. I can get rid of some cows. Well, dump Phyllis. Sorry, old bag. I got so many cows, I'm tempted to sell another one. I might have 5 patches. Let me sort these by faction. How many patches do I have? 1, 2, 3, 4. I already got 4 in my deck. We'll sell off the 5th. Are they adding trading to this game or not? Because if they are, it influences what I want to sell. Like, how many Heifergeist do I have now? God, my blue cards are killer. I might have 1 too many Heifergeists. But I can't tell. We won't risk it. I have 4 Chestburster. Might sell Record Thug. Let's sell another cow. Can I go down to 2 cows? I'll sell 1. I'm scared. Sand stuff? I could get rid of another jackal. They're okay. I could sell the normal sand foot. I might sell a normal toilet. God, I got 3 rainbow gnomes. We'll dump 1. Is that enough? Alright, 33. How many more chests do we have left? 15? I can't do this. This is too many. This really is too many. I gotta get 15 more cards? I'm gonna get rid of 1 cough syrup. And I can get that back easy. I can get that back easy. We'll dump that. That's easy. But I can get rid of a falling star. Tempest is meh. I think I got multiple Field of Nightmares. We'll dump a Magic Hands. And that's already full. Alright, we did it. We got to it. We're back. Maybe we should have sold off a Sandfoot. We didn't. Alright. Ghost Ninja. Pretty meh. Not even gold. Maybe the gold. Let's keep moving. Oh yeah, we talked about that infinite floop thing. Dragonfoot? I got a gold one, dude. This doesn't faze me. I still might play it in a blue deck, but it's not, like, crazy. Alright. Getting towards the end, guys. I'll throw y'all a shout-out again. DUJ2? Thank you. And AllStar1402? Thank you too, man. Now I'm pretty sure I'm at 4 Psionic Architects. We'll do a blind one. It sounded normal to me. It sounded normal. Looking at chat, nothing yet. What do we got? Someone said bubblegum butt. If it's another red island, god dang. That was not worthy of a blind opening. How do I tell them that when I'm doing blind, it needs to be a good card? He's okay. He's a wannabe dark angel. Alright, we got another Diamond Dan. If that was gold, that would have been broken, dude. But now, I have 2 Diamond Dan. And I'm at like 2 to 3 cough syrup. Let's keep moving. We're down to the last 9, dudes. Let's go hard. Second, Druzam Jin. Pardon me, Struzam Jin. Oh my god, all of my decks are gonna be so crazy. My blue deck is gonna have double Diamond Dan, double Struzan gin, heifergeists everywhere. We're down to 8 dudes. Alright. Oh my god, this is the one that I wanted! Wait for chat to see it. I'm changing heroes. Yeah. 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 Alright. I like Dr. Donut, because every 5 turns, you can bring a creature from your graveyard back to the hand. Ash, every 4 turns, you can return any card from your discard pile back to your hand. So, every one of my decks just got better. I have to power level him now. And imagine my Psionic Architect deck with Ash as the hero. Do you guys even know how many spells I'm gonna be getting back from the graveyard? This is debatably one of the best cards that we've unlocked. This may have been the best one. Alright, we'll go blind. See if I can do a blind ban. I saw it though, I think it's a sand card. That's all I saw though. I know it's sand. I saw sand. Sandwich? It's okay. I have sandwiches. I wish I had her sandwiches. But they're sandy. I got a gold sandwich. It's okay, dude. And I have a couple normal ones. What's the attack? 25 for 4 mana? I don't know. Last 5, dudes. Oh my god. This has been an emotional roller coaster. Pie Storm. Pikachu, you look tired? Yeah, dude. I can't handle this adrenaline dump of opening up algebraic chests for an hour and a half. Cave of Solitude. Oh my god. We can't do gambles. Mod bot will just crash. I'm sorry. Down to the final 3. We'll go triple blind. Come on, guys, give me something. Give me a hint. Give me a hint. Algebraic? God's Source Rex ain't bad. I have a gold one. Heal your heroes equal to this creature's attack. The combos are gonna be crazy. This... I need to find some way to pump it up its defense crazy. And then keep it alive at the same time. And then... Even if I run out of cards, I'll be fine. But that could be cool in a fatigue deck. Alright, this is the second to the last chest. Kinda sad. Yeah, cough syrup and floop that last one and you gain 40 health. Alright, people are saying different things. Someone's saying gold cactus? Wow, dude. 5 mana. 37-18. Floop him for 2 mana. Deal damage to the creature in the opposing lane equal to this creature's defense. And his defense is super buff. So normally he's only a 12. But with 18, he's hitting for 18. Pre-floop. Yeah, pre-building pump up. Okay, guys, my brain is so fried, instead of clicking to open up the last chest, I almost clicked stop streaming on my Twitch thing. Whoops. Alright, last one. How could we not do it blind? If it is another detective, I am gonna be so sad. Please don't be a detective! Give me a hint. Ah, we sold one of these. Ultimate magic hands. Choose a creature and send it back to your opponent's hand. Not too bad, not too good. Wow, guys. Let's go back to the card list. We beefed up my inventory space. Unbelievable. Corn cards. And look, everything that I haven't touched yet has a new banner on it. So these are the things that we pulled out of $150 worth of cards. Corn was okay. We got a Sludger, Marianne, Husker Bat, Husker Giant, and Corn Lord, and Captain Taco. Respect. For blue, we got a Diamond Dan, Dragonfoot in gold and in normal, Ghost Hag, Heifergeist in gold and normal. God. I thought we got a gold Psionic Architect. I don't know. Oh, he is gold there. We're up to 4 Psionic Architects. Later, Neo. Double Struzan Jin. We got another Wisp. And another Extra Large Spirit Soldier. For Swamps, we got 3 Chestbursters. Another Davy Bear. Another Dr. Death. A Green Mermaid. Another Immortal Maze Walker. Another Rainbow Barfer. Another Steak Chop, our first Steak Chop, and some commons. For Heart, we got a Cottonsaurus, Detective Bobby, and gold. A Dog Boy, Good King Wonderful, double Gold Sergeant Mushrooms, that's a game breaker. Normal Mushroom, cows, everywhere there's cows, and Well-Dressed Wolf. For Sand, we pulled Gold Cactus Thug, Normal Cactus Thug, Fummy, Gold Lady Mary. Did we get a Gold Sand Angel? That may have been an old one. Oh no, I got that from something else. Sandfoot, Sandwich, and then Rainbow, Detective Sally, Gold, Normal Sally, Gold Ghost Ninja, Normal Ninja. Ice Pally's kind of scrubby. And we closed out with a Pickler. Heroes may have been the best thing, dude. We got our hands on Ash now. Wow. Click him. I can't click him. There we go. 4 turns. Return any card from your discard pile back to your hand. That's one of the best things. I hear you guys spamming spin that wheel. You guys are monsters. What am I gonna get, 100 gems? I just got 250. That was too close. Alright guys, that's the end of this Card Wars video. Thanks again, DUJ2 and All-Star. You guys are crazy. Much appreciated. Thanks for watching, guys. Phone Cats.